Welcome to my closet, and not the one that I was hiding for 4 years. the one that I keep my clothes in.
They gonna hear my voice, ain't gonna make my choice. I'm gonna make some noise in my life, baby. They gonna watch my words, ain't gonna write my verse.
Thank you to LuxStyle for sponsoring today's video.
Hi, so over the past month, I have accumulated a very diverse collection of clothing. My sort of like motto has been, why stick to one style when I can experiment with multiple? So I thought that I would gather all of the items that I've purchased and put them into this one video for you guys. All of the non-thrifted items are linked in the description, although I would always advise for you guys to look for more sustainable options like thrifting or Depop or ThredUp or any sort of secondhand, more sustainable small business shop ideas. That is the direction that I'm moving in, though you will see some items in this video from said stores, and just know that I am making progress slowly but surely. So if you guys have seen either of my two outfit Pinterest boards, one being titled Fit and the other being Style Exploration, you know that I cannot really stick to one style. I like a bunch of pieces individually that don't really fit into one category, and I think that that will shine through in this haul. So I thought that I would start with the first items that I purchased about a month back from ASOS, which I know is not the best shop. This is the first of many button-down tees that you will see in this video. I bought this because I really liked the salmon color, and I also thought that the lighter, like flowy fabric was very nice for summer. It has proven to be great for warm weather, and all my other button-down shirts are more uniform, so this definitely stands out a bit more. Next, we have this like beigey peach compression shirt with like a risen neck. I wouldn't call it a turtleneck because it's not. When I bought this, I thought that it would be a very nice like base to a lot of outfits. I could layer things over it, or I could just wear it on its own and it's comfortable. Since buying it, I've only worn it once, so maybe not my best purchase, but who knows, maybe I will start wearing this in the near future. The final item from ASOS is this Dickies Worldwide t-shirt. I thought that I definitely needed kind of a basic tee in my closet collection. And the logo is printed smaller in the front and then large on the back, which I really liked. I've also only worn this once or twice since purchasing it, but I did try it on for this video with a pair of boyfriend jeans, and I really liked how it looked with the high-rise waist. So I think you guys can expect to see this outfit maybe when the weather cools down a bit more. So you guys might be a little bit shocked when you see the next item because it does not have the same vibe as those three shirts, but this is by far my favorite item. This is from the Misbehave Sport collection, although I'm of course not using it for sport. I don't think most people do. I really love these contour lines. And just kind of the whole look, my parents think it looks like a swim shirt, but I feel like if you pair it with the right pants and shoes and accessories, it can make a really interesting outfit. I did wear this shirt in Rome, which you guys could have seen in my Rome vlog, and I did an Instagram post, which is like one of my most popular Instagram posts on my entire feed, so I know you guys like this item as well. It was definitely pricier. I don't usually spend 120 euro on a shirt, but I thought it sparked a lot of joy. And if you guys have seen my style exploration board on Pinterest, this is very like Alan Rafara vibes. I am very intrigued by his style and definitely want to venture a little more into that realm of fashion. Why am I speaking so strangely? I never talk like this. Sticking with the like edgier vibe, if you will. I got these leather pants from Depop. They're very long and a bit large around the waist, but I think it gives a cool cinched look. I love buying from Depop. You do have to be careful that people aren't just like purchasing items and putting them right up for sale. I know that there's quite a few people who will buy from like Shein, which is very bad, and then they'll put them on their Depop site. But if you're just conscientious, you can find a lot of great small businesses and also people just trying to sell clothes that they no longer care about or no longer wear. Also, the long length is not a problem because I will probably keep these for the rest of my life. And if you tuck them into a boot or just into any other high top shoe, such as a, I don't know, maybe one from the Dior X Air Jordan collection. Speaking of, today's video is sponsored by LuxStyle.cc. Roll the clip.
Hi, sorry to interrupt, but I wanted to take a second and talk about today's sponsor of the video, which is a shoe company called Luxstyle.cc. So I've heard quite a lot of people argue that the most important part of every outfit is the shoes, and if their shoe game is bad, then the entire outfit is bad. Now, I personally have always been really interested in designer shoes, but never understood why they're so expensive. Like, literally, why am I gonna pay $10,000 for a shoe? I'm not. So Luxstyle.cc is here to take those concerns away. They have a massive collection of high quality replica, otherwise known as fake designer shoes. My personal favorites are the Dior Jordans, which they did send me. They sent them in the mail and the German DHL Postal Service lost them and were so unhelpful when we filed a complaint. So unfortunately, I cannot show you guys the shoes, but I can show you a bunch of the images on their website. They also have a selection of bags, wallets, belts, and accessories. So if this sounds interesting to you, this is a great alternative to designer shoes. So the link to their site is in the description. Thanks again to Luxstyle for sponsoring today's video.
Okay, so the next item, let's just say I have mixed feelings about. So this is a cardigan, a red smiley face cardigan from Cider. There's two things about this. First of all, I ordered the smallest size that they had, which was a small. And this is after it was shrunk 2 times in the wash. I'm also 5'11" for, you know, scale comparison. I intentionally shrunk it. Now it fits a bit better, but it is so large, especially for a small. I cannot imagine if I would have ordered a medium or a large. But also, I've had such a difficult time styling it. I tried putting a white button-down shirt under it, not a vibe. I tried taking the white shirt out, a little more of a vibe, but still not a vibe. Next up from Jaded London, which I kind of love Jaded London. Their collections are always super dope and unique, so I recommend. But of course, I had to get the most basic thing on the site. That didn't work. Patchwork jeans. I've worn these on Instagram already, so this should not come as a surprise to any of my Instagram followers. I really try not to buy trendy items because, of course, trends only last for so long. But the only exception is when I actually really like an item and it also happens to be trending, which is what happened with these. So I really recommend these, but you can also look at some other things on Jaded's site because I think that they have some very individual and cool collections. Cool probably was not my best adjective. What else? Swaggy, dope, sexy. So about a month ago, I uploaded a video called Woke Up in Portugal. Me and my family took an incredible trip to Portugal. What a surprise considering it's titled Woke Up in Portugal. I know, real creative liberty there. Anyway, for those of you who have seen that video, I went shopping in that video and didn't show you guys what I bought because I was saving it for this haul video. So the wait is over, you all can exhale now. I'm gonna show you what I got. Hey, look, it's the pants that I wore with all of the ASOS items. Yup. These I got from the Carhartt Whip store. And you know, I could make up a whole story about how I found these, but I'm just gonna be completely honest. It's because of Hannah Lee Duggan. If you have seen her videos, you probably are saying, yep, we are tracking. Something about these pants just makes me feel like kind of cool. It's weird to explain, I promise, but one, they're easy to pair with a lot of things, especially in my closet because I love browns, I love beiges, I love whites. So the next item are the jeans that I'm wearing right now. Let me make them look nice. The reason I bought these is, yeah, they're nice jeans. They're good, right? But the people in the store were really nice to me and kept giving me compliments, and I'm telling myself it's not just because they wanted me to buy something, because they actually really cared about me and thought I was really cool, but the truth behind that is they probably just wanted my business. And they did a great job. They got it. So go you, Levi's, Lisbon. Okay, there might be some rain ASMR in the background. The last store that I went to in Portugal was this really cute thrift store called Tropical Beiro. And I got this shirt. I really don't know what the design is on it, but I think that it's cute. I think that it is very lightweight. Again, good for summer. And you guys know that I love these button-down shirts. The next item is the shirt that I'm currently wearing from Moschino. Except for that, it was 20 euro because I got it from Vinted. I believe it's only a Germany thing, so if you live in Germany, Vinted is a great secondhand app website. It says that it's supposed to stop raining in 30 minutes, so I'm just gonna cut the cameras for a second and talk to you guys about me and Carmen's podcast, and I'll be back later.
Hi, so for those of you who have not already seen the trailer video that I uploaded last week, Carmen and I started a podcast together, and the first episode is out now. I am so, so excited for you guys to hear it, and you can keep up with us on our podcast Instagram at theoverthinking.podcast. It is available on all major streaming platforms, link in description. Enjoy!
Woo! And we're back! So I hope you guys are excited for that podcast because I totally am. Let's continue with the clothing haul. So following this sustainability vibe, I know that some of you guys have seen my Brussels vlog, which is the last video I uploaded on my channel. In that vlog, I also went thrifting and did not show you guys what I bought because I'm showing you guys right now. Woo! Another button-down shirt. Who would have seen this coming? Anyway, this is a very large sage green shirt. I bought this one because I really loved how big and uniform it was. I think it's very like spring vibes, but also because as you guys probably just saw in that little podcast insert, sage green is like the main color for our podcast and our Instagram theme. From the same thrift store in Brussels, for the same price, I got this t-shirt. It's a bit smaller, but I really like it. Unfortunately, it was in the wash the day that I was filming these like fisheye outfit videos. So I will just insert a couple Instagram photos that I took. I just paired it with like a white button-down shirt, and I really like how it looks. The final thrifted item from Brussels were these pants, and literally, okay, I walked into this thrift store, right? And I'm looking, I'm looking, and I see pants that are 28 waist, 34 length, and I'm like, wait a minute. Never in my life have I seen pants that are in my size. They were 13 euro, which is a bit more expensive for a thrift store, but they do seem in very good condition, and they make me very happy. I often pair this with this shirt, which is the last clothing item until we move on to accessories. In Brussels, we also went to Urban Outfitters. I only got one item from the Urban Outfitters renewal section, which is a bit more sustainable than the regular Urban Outfitters section because it is just recycled clothing, and it's unique as well, so it's very comfortable. I finally have a cute and comfortable clothing item, which is nice. And if you pair it with the right accessories, you can still feel like you are wearing a very nice outfit. What a segue. Let's get into accessories. So 2 weeks ago, I did not own a single ring. Oh my god, what? Yeah, I know. Now I do. So I'd be lying if I told you guys that I knew where all my rings were from. I know that I got one in Rome. I accidentally stole this pearl one from my friend in Brussels. I am so sorry, Masha. Thank you for letting me borrow it. I promise you that I did not mean to accidentally put it in my backpack. I got this pearl necklace with the little Saturn logo on it from a small business on Depop. The seller was so kind and they shipped it in one day. And you all know that the German DHL system is not that efficient. You know, the Dior Jordan situation, don't even get me started. So the fact that this came the next day was very impressive. I got these glasses on Amazon. I just searched Y2K sunglasses. They're fun, kind of hard to see out of, but I think they're cute. And you know, I thought I would save this item for last because it might make you laugh. I've had these sunglasses for 2 years and they are one of my favorites. I get to Brussels, the sunglasses are right here, right? Like this. I go out for the day and I come back and they're gone. I had been on a train that day, in the car, all over the town. I was like, yeah, you know what? It was about damn time. So I go out, I spend $22 on these, and I come back, and my friend's mom said, hey, Will, you dropped your sunglasses in the car. So now I have two. So guys, if you like this video and you like my style, please keep up with my Pinterest boards and my Instagram. I think that that is going to be a great source of inspiration if you guys like certain items from this. Stay tuned for style-related episodes on the podcast. Ah, so excited. And make sure to subscribe. We are about to hit 16,000 subscribers, which is wild. Wild, absolutely wild. Thanks again to Luxstyle.cc for sponsoring this video. Thank you guys for watching. Love you all. Bye.